Hello everyone, this is Dr. K. Jagannayaki, Professor in MBA Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So today I want to discuss with you about perfect computation. In previous session, we discussed about market and market structures, and also we discussed about the types of computation. One is perfect and another one is imperfect computation. So let us start. What is perfect computation? So after going through this topic, the learner will be able to understand the meaning of perfect computation, features of perfect computation, characteristics of perfect computation, elements of perfect computation, advantages and disadvantages, market equilibrium under perfect computation. So already we have an idea about perfect computation, where we can find large number of sellers and buyers. They involve in buying and selling of goods at equilibrium price, which is fixed by the industry. See, whatever goods they used to sell, all the goods are homogeneous in nature. There are no substitutes available in the market. So sellers are price takers as they sell their products at equilibrium price only. So equilibrium price means whatever the industry fixes, and that price the individual companies has to assume. This market is hypothetical and is myth, as no such market exists actually. It is based on number of hypothetical conditions like no transport cost, no advertisement cost, full knowledge of markets among buyers and sellers. All these things we used to consider as assumptions of perfect competitions. So coming to the examples of perfect competition, so we have foreign exchange markets, even agricultural markets, then internet related industries, software, free software, street food vendors. Because there we can see number of sellers, those who are going to deal with identical business. So that is the best example of perfect competition. Then coming to the features of perfect competition, the first feature is that many sellers. So as there are number of sellers, any single seller or firm cannot influence a given market price. So an individual seller or a firm is a price taker. As in any industry, there are number of firms available. So no single firm, they cannot fix their own price. They should take the price from the industry. So whatever the industry decide, and that is the equilibrium price, and every individual firm they have to take the same price. So in that way the firms they become price takers, and many buyers also there. So as there is a large volume of buyers available in the market, any single buyer, they cannot influence a given market price. This is because individual demand is a very small fraction in the total market demand. So buyer is also a price taker. So individual buyer also you cannot influence, because it is a combination of, as we previously we discussed about N composite ratio. So when you are combining all the firms, and whatever price decided by the industry, even the buyer will also consume the same price. So buyer will also become a price taker in case of perfect competition. Then comes homogeneous products. So in case of perfect markets or perfect competition, all firms are producers. They will produce and sell identical products. So identical means same in respect of size, shape, color, packaging, etc. And there is no difference in between various products which are perfect substitutes for each other. So wherever you will go, we'll get the same type of quantity, quality, price, packaging, everything same. So that type of products are known as homogeneous products. The next one is free entry and exit. So there is perfect freedom for new firms or sellers to enter a market or an industry without any legal, economic or any other type of restrictions or barriers. Like the existing producers or sellers are free to leave the market. So in case of perfect competition, whenever you want, you can enter into the market, and if you want to exit from the market, that is also very easy comparatively with imperfect competition. Next, perfect knowledge. So in perfect markets, all the buyers and sellers, they will have perfect knowledge regarding the market conditions, especially the prevailing market price, the quantity of supply. So a single price would prevail for a commodity in the entire market. So that is the reason we can find fixed price. If you go wherever you go in the entire market, will have only one single price. And next one is perfect mobility of factors of production. So no entry and exit barriers for individuals and firm. So even as an individual, if you want to enter, you can. And if you want to leave the market easily, you can leave. There is no kind of legal, economic and other kind of restrictions or barriers to the individual persons as well as to the firms. Then transport cost. So it is hypothetical assumption that there are no transport cost. And next one is non-intervention by the government. So it is also assumed that government does not interfere with the working of a market economy. So it means that no controls on the supply of raw materials, tariffs, subsidies, rationing, licensing, etc. So these are some of the features of perfect competition. Then coming to the characteristics of perfect competition, no firm holds substantial market share. It means that as it is perfect competition where we can have large number of players in the market, no single firm can hold major market share. So, because price-taking producers and also price-taking consumers available in the market. So, that is the reason you cannot say this is the firm which has a major share in the market. And second one is industry output is standardized. So, as all the sellers or the producers, they used to produce homogeneous goods and services, perfectly elastic demand we can see in case of perfect competition, and there is no freedom, no startup cost and no economic modes available. So it is free from all kind of entry exit barriers. So these are the major characteristics of a perfect competition. Then coming to the elements of perfect competition, no monopoly, so no markets with just one seller. So in general, that we can say in case of imperfect markets, if you are going to come out with a new product or service, there is no other competitors available in the market, then that type of market is known as monopoly. So you are the whole and soul, you can fix your own price, so you can capture the total share of the market. And no duopoly, no markets with just two sellers, and no oligopoly, no markets with too few sellers, and no oligospony. Spony means buyers, no markets with too few buyers. So in case of perfect markets, we'll have large number of buyers available in the market, and no monospony, no markets with just one buyer. So we cannot find the market with only one single buyer in case of perfect competition, and no barriers to entry. So no obstacles blocking newcomers. The new firms, if they want to enter easily, they can enter into the perfect markets. So these are the elements of perfect competition. Then coming to the advantages and disadvantages of perfect competition. So let us start with advantages. It helps to allocate resources to most efficient use. So whatever resources available with the industry, they can be allocated very easily to all the firms in a most efficient manner. And it encourages efficiency, as people they used to produce identical goods. So we can improve their efficiency, and consumers benefit. Consumers charge lower price because there are number of competitors available in the market. So as a result, even the customers can also avail cost benefits from perfect competition and responsive to customer wishes. So whatever they used to produce, it depends upon the consumer's taste and preferences. And it has some disadvantages also. The conditions are very strict. There are few perfectly competitive markets. So you cannot decide that all the markets will be perfectly competitive, but we can have only few perfect competitive markets because of the stringent rules and regulations, insufficient profits for investment. So as there are number of players in the market, so the profits they used to distribute among all the members of an industry. So as a result, whatever profits the companies want to generate, that may not be up to the extent. And lack of product variety. See, as it is related to only identical or homogeneous goods, there is no question of seeking for different kinds of varieties of products available in the market. And unequal distribution of goods and income, that may also one type of disadvantage with perfect competition. Then coming to market equilibrium under perfect competition. Equilibrium under perfect competition means it is a state where the market demand matches market supply. When market demand and market supply balance each other, there occurs a situation of equilibrium in the market. So both should be equal, demand equal to supply. So during equilibrium, price and quantity become stable. Equilibrium is the state of no change. The stable price is also known as equilibrium price, and the stable quantity known as equilibrium quantity. So where both market demand is equal to market supply. So that is known as market equilibrium, that we can see in case of perfect competition. Then there are two types of competitions we used to see equilibrium. One is short run equilibrium, another one is long run equilibrium. So coming to the first one, short run equilibrium under perfect competition. A firm is in equilibrium in the short run when it has no tendency to expand or contrast its output and wants to earn maximum profit or to incur minimum losses. The ultimate objective of any business organization is maximization of profit and minimization of losses. So whenever the firm want to maintain short run equilibrium, means the firm, they do not want to expand further or contrast their output. So within that limited or available resources, they want to maximize the profit and minimize their losses. So the short run is a period of time in which the firm can vary its output by changing the variable factors of production. The fixed factors, they do not change whatever may be the level of production. but only just by making changes in the variable factors, the company can easily attain their objectives. The number of firms in the industry is fixed because neither the existing firms can leave nor new firms can enter it. So as a result, the number of firms remains constant. There is no change in terms of the number of firms. But without changing this and making the number of firms fixed, they want to earn maximum profits. At the same time, they want to reduce minimum losses. Then coming to the assumptions of short-run equilibrium, perfect competition. So this is based on the following assumptions. The first one is all firms use homogeneous factors of production. So number of firms available in the industry, every firm, they will produce similar type of or identical goods and services. And the volume of production, everything remains the same. There is no change in terms of factors of production. And firms are of different efficiency. So whenever you are going to compare one firm with other firm's efficiency, there will be some kind of variation in terms of their efficiency levels. Cost curves of firms vary from each other. As efficiency vary, so cost curves may also vary from each other. All firms sell their products at the same price and determined by the demand and supply of the industry, so that the price of each firm, it becomes the same, and where the average return is equal to marginal return. And firms produce and sell different quantities. So it depends on individual firms. Some firms, they produce little amount of goods and services, and some they will produce more. It depends on the demand from the consumers in the market. Then second type of equilibrium is long run equilibrium under perfect competition. So long run equilibrium means it is a period on which all factors of production are variable. When some firms are earning super normal profit, so whenever average return is greater than average cost in the short run, it attracts a large number of firms into the industry. As a result, output increases, resulting in fall in market price, and super normal profit will be wiped away, and the normal profit will continue in the long run. And second case is when some firms suffer losses. When we say it is loss, means if AR is less than AC in the short run, they start leaving the industry in the long run. Reduction in the number of firms leads to contraction of industry's output. So gradually even industry size will also become less. As a result, price increases, and due to this, all losses will be wiped away and only normal profit will continue in the long run. In long run equilibrium under perfect competition. So in the long run, firms in perfect competition can make only normal profit. They cannot make super normal profit, which is not possible like in case of short run equilibrium under perfect competition. And freedom of entry and exit eliminates the short run abnormal profit and short run losses. In the long run equilibrium, there is no incentive for firms to enter or exit the industry. So price and output determination in the long run under perfect competition. In long run, the firm is in equilibrium at the point where long run marginal cost is equal to long run marginal revenue. At the same time, long run average cost is equal to long run average revenue. If it is assumed that all the firms are facing the similar cost conditions, all the firms are in equilibrium at point where all will earn only normal profit with LAC is equal to LMC, which is equal to LAR equal to LMR. So there is no difference in between marginal cost, marginal revenue, average cost, average revenue in the long run. So that kind of equilibrium we can see in case of perfect competition in the long run. Then coming to the practical significance of perfect competition, a larger number of small firms and many buyers do not possess the power to influence the behavior of the participants in the marketplace. See here, irrespective of the consumer's behavior, the firms, they will act against, they want to maintain existence in the market. And the power is thoroughly dispersed throughout the marketplace. So the power, it may not be concentrated at one place. It will be dispersed all over the market. Perfect competition rarely exists in the real world. So theoretically, we are talking these many things, but in real life sense, it may not be up to the mark. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.